When it comes to skincare, I'm sure you all know retinol is the gold standard. Let's go back to what it does. It stimulates collagen production, boosts elasticity, fights fine lines and wrinkles, targets acne, removes sun damage, and inhibits hyperpigmentation. So talk about a multitasker, right? But with that said, it's important that all of the products in your routine complement one another so you can actually see results. This is sadly one of the reasons why you don't get results with retinol. You could be mixing ingredients that cancel each other out, or worse, destroying your skin barrier. In this video, I wanna make it quick. I wanna go over what you should not mix with your retinols. So stay with me till the end. And real quick, guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on next to it to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Now, retinol is a type of retinoid, which is made from vitamin A. It's a pretty small molecule that goes deep beneath the epidermis into your dermis. Once it's in the middle layer of the skin, retinol will help neutralize free radicals. This will then boost the production of elastin and collagen, which creates that plumping effect and reduces the appearance of fine lines and wrinkles and enlarged pores. That's one of the main reasons as to why it's even used in the first place. And different products will contain varying strengths, and selecting the right strength depends on your skin's reactivity and previous experience with retinol. If you're new to retinol or have sensitive skin, go with a 0.3% one. If you can tolerate that one well, then you go opt for concentrations of up to 1% for more pronounced results. And when choosing a retinol product, make sure to choose one that clearly states the retinol percentage. A lot of products don't tell you what percentage of retinol that is in them, which is another reason why you might have given up on retinol, since it might have been too harsh and you're using the wrong percentage all along. The whole point of this video is to make sure we can avoid unnecessary skin irritation, damaging the skin barrier, and making sure the other ingredients we use don't backfire on us. Does that make sense? So with that said, the first ingredients you want to avoid while using retinol are your AHAs and BHAs, which can dry the skin and cause further irritation if your skincare routine already includes retinol. AHAs are your lactic acids, glycolic acids, and mandelic acids, for example. And your BHA is going to be your salicylic acid. These ingredients can be way too exfoliating, which means they're likely to cause more irritation and dryness when you use them with your retinol. And on top of that, they will increase sun sensitivity even more. But if you want to combine them alongside retinol, you must alternate them every morning and start it off slowly, so not on the same day. This is especially true if you have eczema and skin sensitivity issues. So that's a good way to get around that problem. The second ingredient you want to avoid while using retinol is your vitamin C serums. But hear me out, there is a caveat to this that I want you to know. Vitamin C is one of the most potent antioxidants we have in skincare, so technically it can help boost retinol's protection against environmental stressors and UV damage. That's why you often see it paired up in the same products if you're targeting hyperpigmentation and premature aging, like the Paul's Choice 1% Retinol and Vitamin C, right? Now, I'll tell you why this may be an exception in just a bit, but for some people, the combination can be too drying or sensitizing. But don't worry if you fall into this category. The trick is to use the vitamin C in the morning, layer it with sunscreen, and use the retinol at night. The reason why a Paul's Choice product can get away with this is because of the addition of licorice root extract, which soothes the redness and irritation from the retinol and vitamin C combo simultaneously and preserves their benefits, which you can find below in the description box as my affiliate. The third ingredient you want to avoid while using retinol is your benzoyl peroxides. Now, benzoyl peroxide is one of the most effective acne-fighting ingredients on the market, right? But here's the thing. Using benzoyl peroxide in retinol or even tretinoin, which you can find more info in my video about tretinoin here, using them in the same routine is counterproductive, as the two ingredients neutralize each other, which can decrease their efficacy. A good way to get around this is to use benzoyl peroxide in the morning and keep retinol in your nighttime routine. If you find formulations that contain benzoyl peroxide and, let's say, a retinoid, they're specifically formulated in a certain way so that it can work and not dry out the skin. And many of those may be prescription options. So there you have it. Those are the three ingredients I would not use in the same routine with retinol, your AHAs and BHAs, your vitamin C serums, and benzoyl peroxide. But the real question is, what do I do if I already damaged my skin with retinol? Because mixing the wrong ingredients and using too high of a percentage, and even using more than a pea-sized amount for some, can result in the inflammation of the lipid layer of your skin, which is where you'll find all your skin's precious fatty acids, cholesterols, and ceramides that are very important to retain. This is why it's important to keep on top of the skin's hydration levels when incorporating retinol, because side effects are real and they can be very drying. So if you look in the mirror and can see skin inflammation, redness, unusual texture, go ahead and stop the retinol. If you actually have a damaged skin barrier, it'll feel like you're having a hot shower on top of a sunburn. It's not worth it to further damage the skin. Start to evaluate what went wrong. Take a step back and retrace your steps. Was the retinol too strong? Did you combine it with any other ingredients that I mentioned? Are you using essential oils or fragrances in your routine? Do you skip the sunscreen? What I would do is go back to the basics, which is a gentle cleanser, clean moisturizer, and SPF, which I've linked all of them down below for you. Taking a break from actives will give your skin the best opportunity to repair itself back to normal. And in the meantime, switch to a moisturizer that is focused on skin barrier remodeling. The Pyunkang Yule Calming Moisture Barrier Cream is an affordable one that has cica as well as made of casocide, which are proven ingredients to restore the skin barrier even faster and provide tremendous hydration to the skin. I'm more curious to hear from you guys though. What are your thoughts on retinol? Do you love it? Do you hate it? Leave them down below, and until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.